गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डिमेंशनल फॉर्मूला। सो ऑन दैट डे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन इज कन्वर्जन ऑफ यूनिट्स एंड सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन इज वी आर वेरीफाइंग वेदर द फॉर्मूला इज करेक्ट और नॉट। दिस इज अवर सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस थर्ड एप्लीकेशन हुज नेम इज मेकिंग न्यू फॉर्मूला ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज। That means with the help of this dimensional analysis concept, we will be making a new formula of a physical quantity. That means we will be having some physical quantity and we will be making the formula of that physical quantity. Suppose a stone is tied with a thread and you are rotating it in a circular path. That means a force is acting on the stone. Due to that force only, it is rotating in circular path. So you will means do some observations. Suppose the mass of stone is doubled, you will observe the force gets doubled, and by observation you have found with this force, central force, it depends on mass. This central force that is acting on the stone, it depends on velocity, and you change the radius of string, the force is going to change. So the force depends on the radius of string. So all these factors, they come by the observation part. So you means roughly you will prepare the force depend on mass, force depend on velocity, force depend on radius of string. But we don't know the exact formula how force depends. How will you go on? You will go like this. Force, it depend on mass, it depend on velocity, it depend on radius. How much power of mass, we don't know, A. How much power of velocity, we don't know, B. How much power of radius of string is, we don't know, C. It depends on this. When we remove this, always you know in physics, it will be replaced by is equals to constant of proportionality, MA, VB, RC. So our target is to find the powers like this. You know that there is a principle, its name is principle of homogeneity. Principle of homogeneity. It says that the dimensions of this right hand side and the dimensions of this left hand side, they are equal. You know that the dimensional formula of force is this. We have already derived it, MLT minus 2. That means M is having 1, L is having 1, T minus 2. So the dimensions of force are M1, L1, T minus 2. So these are the dimensions of force. So force is having dimensions of this M1, L1, T minus 2 is equals to. So K is not having any kind of dimensions as it is a constant. So mass is having a dimension of mass M, and mass power is A. So we will put here as a, sorry, like this. So we will put here as A. First I have written the dimensions of force, then I have written equals to, K is not having any dimension. Then I have written the dimension of mass. Mass dimension is having power A, so I have written power A. Velocity. Velocity is having a dimension of LT minus 1. You have already did this in the last lecture. And its power is B. Radius is having the dimension of length. This radius, it's having the dimension of length. And its power is C. Now you will do the comparative study. Here mass is having A power and here mass is having 1 power. Equals to sign only exists if the same power of mass is here and the same power of mass is here. If mass power is here 3 and mass power is 1, how it can be equal to? No, it can't be equal to. So we will compare this. So here mass is having power A, here mass is having power 1. So the power of the value of A is going to be 1. So what's value of L? L is having value B also and L is having value C also. So these are the values of L because they are multiplication sign. LB into LC, LB plus C. And what is here power of L? L is having power of 1. So B plus C is equals to 1. So we have found out the value of this. So T, what is the power of here T? T the power is minus B. And here what is the power of T? Minus 2. So these two are equal. Minus B is equals to minus 2. Minus cut with minus B is equals to 2. So you have found the value of B. Put this value here. B is equals to 2. 2 plus T is equals to 1. So C is equal to 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. So you have found the value of C also. Now you are having the value of A also, B also, and C also. And what is this force? Force is equals to K. Mass power A. Velocity power B. And radius power C. So F is equals to K. Mass. What is the value of A we have found? 1. What is the value of V we have found? V is V. B value is 2. And R is R. C value is minus 1. So minus 1 goes down. F is equals to K. MV square. R minus 1 means it will go in the downward side. This is the formula we have generated. So this is the formula of centripetal force. F is equal to K MV square upon R. So we have derived new formula with the help of dimensional analysis. So this is the means technique of making a formula. You will take another example. Time period T of oscillation. This is the time period of pendulum suppose. Big T. Pendulum oscillation doing oscillation. Pendulum is doing oscillation and that oscillation is having a period of time t. T depends on mass of particle. So depends on mass, depends on length of pendulum, depends on acceleration due to gravity. Establish a relation between them. So this is the question. We don't know what is the power of M, L, B. We take the power as A, B and C. We will compare both the left hand side and right hand side by using the principle of homogeneity. What is the dimensions of T? M0, L0, T1. Dimension T is having dimension of T only. Yeah? So here mass is having a dimension of big M, L is having a dimension of big L, and acceleration due to gravity is having a dimension of LT minus 2. Acceleration is having a dimension of LT minus 2 and its power is C. So same way, M key power A, and what is the here M key power 0? So A is going to have a value of 0. So what is here L? L B also, L C also. What is the value of L? L B plus C. B plus C is going to have a value of 0. This. And what is this T? T minus 2C. Minus 2C is having a value of 1. Minus 2C is having a value of 1. And C is having a value of this minus 2 goes down. Minus 1 by 2. So we have found the value of C. This C value we will put here. We will get the value of B also. 1 by 2. So T is equals to K, M key power, M is 2 power A, L is 2 power B, G is 2 power C. What is the value of A? 0. What is the power of B? Value of B? 1 by 2. What is the power of C? Minus 1 by 2. You have put here. So T is equals to K, M key power 0, that means 1. It's gone. L 1 by 2, G 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2, what will become? L 1 by 2, G 1 by 2. What is this 1 by 1 by 2? This is under root L by G. So this is the time period of a pendulum. T is equal to K under root L by G. So you have derived the formula like this using with the help of dimensional analysis. So we are moving with our next topic, but that is calculating error in measurements. Suppose you have measured a distance between Delhi to Bombay and there will be errors in that measurement. How you can calculate the error? When you are doing a measurement, no? There are two values. One is a true value, exact value, and one is the measured value, the reading measured by you. Suppose exact distance is 3000, but you have measured 3002. That is measured value. What is the error? Suppose exact distance is 3000 km, you have measured 3200 km.
So measured value is 32 kilometer. And true value is 3000 kilometer. So what is the error? You will minus the measured value, true value from the measured value. You have done measurement of 3200 kilometer. Exact is 3000 kilometer. So what is the error? 200 kilometer. So error is measured value minus true value. So the error is equals to measured value minus true value. So you know that, is true value known to us? I think no. If true value was known to us, why we will be measuring this measured value? If true value is known, we don't need to measure the measured value. So how we are going to find this true value? There is a method to find the true value. We will take so many observations. That means we will calculate the distance from Delhi to Bombay so many times and take the average of all the readings. That means we are going to get a mean value, and that mean value we will take near to the true value. That means first time you have taken the observation from Delhi to Bombay, it is A1. Another time you have taken the observation from Delhi to Bombay, that is A2. Again, Delhi to Bombay, another observation. You will take the mean, add all of them, divide by 3. You are going to get a value. So this value will be very near to the true value. So we will assume this as true value. This is the, you will add all the observations, divide by the number of observations. That means you are taking the mean of all the observations. You are taking the average of all the observations. You are taking the average of the result of all the observations. So you will get a mean value. That will be very, very near to this true value. So what is the error now? Error is, we will measure a value, measured value, then we will subtract the mean value, and mean value is very equals to the true value, then we are going to get the error like this. So error is measured value minus mean value, and you know what is mean value. So this is a mean, A1, A2, A3, An upon N. This is result of first observation, result of second observation, result of third observation, result of last observation divided by the total number of observations. Suppose you have measured a first observation, okay? You are going to get error in this also. So this is the measure, means first measured observation. A1, you're going to get error in this also, no? Yes, you're going to get this error. Suppose this is A1 is the first observation. You subtract the mean from A1. Mean, that is true value. You're going to get the error in A1. Error in A1 observation. You will be having A2 reading. Then subtract the A mean. You are going to get the error in A2 observation. You will find all the errors up to AN. First you will find the mean value. Then you will subtract from A1. From A1, measured A1 value, you will subtract this mean value. You will get the error in A1. You are having A2, subtract the A mean. You will get error in A2. A3, subtract the A mean from A3. So you will get all the errors. The errors can have a negative value or a positive value. Error value can be plus 200 or minus 200. It can be. So you will get all the errors. In step number 1, you will calculate the mean value. In step number 2, you will calculate the error in each observation. Error in first observation, error in second observation. And you know that how to calculate the error. Measured value minus mean value. This is the measured value. This is the mean value. You will get the error in this first measurement. Now add all the errors. Divide by the this number of errors. You will get the mean error value. You will get the mean error value. I have already told you, errors can be positive or negative. you will take only the positive errors, means you will take the modulus of errors. Modulus means if its value is 200 na, minus 200, and if you are going to take its modulus minus 200, its value is going to come 200. Means signs are not considered, only magnitude is considered. So modulus of a1, modulus of a2, modulus of an upon n, you are going to get the mean error value, and this is known as average mean error. In step number third, you are going to calculate the average mean error. In step number one, you will take so many observations, you will find the average of those observations, you will find the mean value. In step number two, you will calculate the error in each observation. Error can be positive or negative. And in step number three, you will calculate the mean average error, like this. Okay, like this. So I will explain you in detail. You will take the observation. Suppose first observation is A1, and second observation is A2, and third observation is A3, and fourth, and fifth, and go on. So many observations you have taken. For step number one. And step number one, now you will find the mean of all observations. Your target is to find the mean value. So how you are going to find? You get the average of all the observations. You will add all the observations up to n, divide by the number of observations. Means 100 values divided by 100. You are going to get a mean. This is your first step. In step number two, you know the formula. How you can calculate the error? You can calculate the error by observed value. What is the observation? If you observed value means minus, if you minus the observed means mean value. What is this? In step number one, you have calculated the mean value. If you minus the observed value, minus means if you subtract the mean value from observed value, then you are going to get the error. Suppose you want to find the error in A1, you will minus the mean value from A1, you will get the error in A1. So this is the sign of error in A1. Delta A1 means error in A1. Similarly, you can find the error in A2 also. See, delta A2, because you are taking this formula, observed value minus mean value, error in observed value. So you are going to get this error in observed value. Similarly, up to an, nth observation, when you minus the mean, you are going to get the error in nth observation. So you have found all the errors in step number 2, all the errors in each observation. In step number 3, you will add all the errors. Some errors can be positive or some errors can be negative. So you will add the modulus of those errors. See, only positive values you will take. You will add all the modulus and divide by the number of observations. How many errors? You are going to get the average mean error. Means you are going to get the delta A mean. You are going to get the average mean error. You have calculated a mean also, and you have calculated the error in mean also. So first you will write a mean when you write the reading. And what is the error? This is the error. Error can be plus or error can be minus. Delta a mean. So this is the way of writing a reading. Suppose a mean comes to be 4. Suppose it comes to be 4. And this delta A mean comes to be 1. Suppose. How you will write this? Means first you will. It is the way of writing the reading. It is the way of writing a measurement. So this is the. When someone asks you, write the measurement. How you will write? First you will write the mean value. Here 4. Okay. Then you will write this plus minus. Then you write this error value. What is the meaning of this? It can be this also. 2. It can be this also. 4, 1, 1, 5. 5, 2, 3. So this is the range. It can be 5, 3 to 5. So answer is coming. Jo, the answer in measurement that is its range. This is the range. This is known as range 3 to 5. So this is the way of representing a measurement. First you will write a measurement. Then you will means give the error, and this error can be in plus also. This error can be in minus also. So your target is to find the A mean, and your target is to find the average mean error. So this is the mean value. And step number one you have calculated, and this is the mean average mean error. So your target is to find both these. Okay, then you will write like this. So for one time you will write plus and one time you will write minus. So this is the range. So value can come in this range 3 to 5. It can be anyone, 3.6 or 3.7. So this is the concept. So your target means way of writing is this 100 positive negative 3. That means it can be 103 or it can be 97. In between 97 to 103 the measurement can be there. So this is the range of measurement, one time plus, one time minus. So first you will write mean, then you will write the average mean error. It can be plus, can be minus. So this is the range of measurement. So this is the way of writing a measurement. How you will write a measurement? Like this. And what is the range of measurement? This is the range. The maximum the value can come in this range. So this is all for today. You will get the homework in a written format. What will be the homework? So the review part, you know that today we have discussed how we can make a formula. First we know the quantities. What is the power? We will assume those powers A, B, C. We will apply the homogeneity principle. We will compare the dimensions on the left hand side and right hand side, and by comparing we will find the value of A, B and C. And next concept is errors. In error, one is measured value, one is true value, but we are not having true value, so we will find the mean value in step number one. We will add all the observations, divide by the number of observations, we are going to get the mean value. Then we will find error in each observation, error in first, error in second, error in third. In step number third, we will calculate, add, we will take the average of all the errors. We are going to get the average mean error. How is the way of writing observation? Mean value plus negative average mean error. So this is the range, one time plus, one time minus. So this is all for today. Hope you enjoyed today's lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.